led by Escobar. Escobar steps in against Mastroni. Escobar wanted after it. Now is Robertson. He'll swing it around the near boards. That one is backhanded up the boards and played out to center, where Lefkoff sent it over to his partner, Skeens. Now in transition, the shot, wrist shot high to Pope. He lost the puck. And now an outlet pass up ahead. Here's Weiser. Tried to cut inside the defenseman, but that was played perfectly there by Skeens. Out to center ice, a bouncing puck was corralled by Donovan momentarily. He got it over to Cope. A backhand shot is turned aside easily there by Yonke. Now here come the chill. That one will be lifted into the near corner. Madsey sends it around the near boards. And now that was picked off momentarily, and it bounces out to center. Robertson will fling it in. That's cut off by O'Brien. Here's Madsey. He'll take a look. Swings it over to Skeens. Skeens back to Madsey in his own zone. And then that one will just be nudged. That one hit off the stick of Kizmatulin, so there will be no icing. With it now, that's Robertson. Around the near boards for Kizmatulin. Now with some space, breaking in is Fondeduz. He's got a man. He lays it over, a shot and a goal. Beautiful. Danbury is on a two-game losing streak. They're 4-6 in their last 10. Don't have the goal loaded up yet in the website. Once it is, I'll be sure to pass that along to everyone. I think it's simply going to be 13 from 12. There's a shot on goal. Here we go. You can say it. Come on. She started to. That one's lifted in and gloved by Yonke. That pass was offline, and it'll be picked up there by Best. He'll retreat into his own end, watched by Wiechek. Period. They trail one zip. Palomeque took the draw for the Colonials, but he was bested there by Escobar. Now weaving out of his own zone with Skeens. Got that one up ahead to Remsen. Remsen failed to get that one in deep, and the Colonials will try another entry. That one's going to be an icing against Donovan. Donovan wins it. Skeens gets that one over to Lefkoff. It's held in by Dent, and now it comes out to center. Circling with it is Donovan. He'll flip it off the boards to himself, and then he lost it, but his teammate was there to bang that one in. That was Remsen. The race is on. Cooley gets it out of their zone. Now Robertson flings that one over to Dent. Out front, it's a goal. What a beautiful feed over to him. And when he fired off the wrist shot, it just rolled up the blade of his stick. He got nothing on that one, unfortunately, for him. Now pass on the right side is directed off of the glass by McEnany into the chill zone. And it's flipped out to center. That one is hoisted towards the net. It's set down, and now the chill will break out. But here's an intercept by Skeens. A shot, a save made by Yonke. Good look there. Bad turnover. That one is sent down the ice. No icing. O'Brien will play that one around to Lefkoff. He'll leave that one back for Skeens. He turns away from the forechecker. That was Gilbert. Now a long stretch pass goes in on Yonke, so no icing. Dent had one of the Gilbert steps in against Weber. Weber wins it. First to get to it was Skeens. He can't clear it, however. He'll try and pin it against the boards. Around it goes. Chasing after it is Weber. Weber will get it, and he'll back that one to the line, and that one was held in. Pad save made by O'Brien. Here's Gilbert. Up top, that shot right on. Save was made on the shot by DeShepherd. Gilbert has it again, down low to Drews. He had it stripped off of his stick by Skeens. Gilbert. Drews was right there, and now here's a chance, and it bounces off of the helmet of Gilbert, and then finally out to center. Here's DeShepherd. Up ahead, his pass was in the skates of Kizmatulin, and that will allow Danbury's number 14, Donovan, to send that one down the ice. Less than a minute remains here on the power play. Now the Colonials will make their change. Streaking down the right side, rubbed out into the boards there. That was Drews. He was sealed off by Levkov. Now there's a race. It's a potential 2-on-0 if they could get to it. With it, that's Weber. He'll skate in. By the time he got to the puck, that potential 2-on-0 had vanished into a 2-on-2. It had really morphed into that. Waning seconds now of the power play, 15. O'Brien will cut that one off and play it around the boards. Puck bounces, though, however, to McCormick. He gets a backhand shot. That was turned aside easily by O'Brien. Remsen is standing in the penalty box, and his time has expired. A successful kill for the Colonials. That will be an icing call. We'll get a faceoff back. And then Dadu steps in against Donovan. Donovan wins the draw, claiming that loose puck was Levkov. Levkov and his partner, Skeens, try to work this one out and break it out. That was touched ahead nicely by Mastroni out to center. Here. That'll be Gilbert's 7th goal of the year. Oh, they're buzzing the tower again. It's loose. That one is played out to center, but it's held in by Dent. Here's Gilbert. Drews with it. The Christopher connection. Check will get an assist as well. Now here's Escobar, turns against Madsey, maintains control of the puck, gets it to Pollitt. Pollitt tried to hit Fondadoos, but that was out of his reach. Now tracking in the far corner for the chill was Vanderhoven, and it's sticked out, and now out to center with it. Here's McEnany. He'll go wide. Face-off, it's whistled out to center into the Colonial zone, no icing. Levkov will send that around the near boards. That will be held in at the left point by Cherry for the chill. Here's Escobar. That one is flipped in, and O'Brien and Donovan in the face-off circle. Severson wins the draw. Escobar nudges that one to the far boards to keep the play alive here for the chill. Here's Best. He's harassed by Skeens. Also helping out was Turner. Now it's loose. Here's Best. Shields the puck away from the defender, but the defender, Levkov, not once but twice, was able to strip him of that. Here's Escobar. Gives it to Best. Best is looking for Escobar on the return pass, but he was covered. Now, DePepper lost control of it at the blue line, but then dove to keep it alive. 20 seconds left here in the first period. We're going to get a penalty. The draw, Pollitt in his own zone. Got it to Escobar. Escobar, his pass was a little bit behind Severson, and that allows Colonials to send it down. Now, dangerous moment there. Fondadoos. I just looked up. Fondadoos is from France. My original thought when I saw his name, oh, he turned it over badly there, was it was going to be pronounced Fondadoos. And if he scores, I've got a special goal call for him. his native tongue. Fondadoo's with it now. Ducks underneath the check of Donovan, and now the puck is pinned to the far boards. Precious power play time rolling off the clock. Here's a two-on-one shorthanded. That shot was ripped wide, a lively bounce off the boards. Donovan had a man with him. He had Cope. Did the right thing and took the shot. Here's Severson. He had it stripped by Weber. And then that one is sent out to center ice. Circling with it into his own zone was Coffin. Gave that one to Robertson. Tried the left side with 13 seconds left. Coffin up ahead. Drews had it, but he ran right into Skeens. And that one bounces off the skate of Robertson. He gave that one over to Cope. But Cope was so far deep that he couldn't really do anything with it. That one comes in, and that one is blocked or aside by Yonke. Weiser had it momentarily. Now that one will just be flipped by Skeens down deep. After it there, first to get to it, was McCormick. Now, on the far boards, it's popped free. That one is banked off the boards. Out front, point-blank scoring chance there. Nice feed from Brady Hill to Remsen. Now on the outside with it, that one will be sent in the corner. Here's Remsen. Out front, there's a great battle going on. It comes in the high slot. Big blocker save made there on a wicked wrister from Madsey. Excellent zone time here for the Colonials. We'll see if they can make it pay off. Bouncing puck. Madsey will get to that. He'll send it towards the net. Cooley needs to ice it. Madsey down low. Here's Remsen with it. He'll leave that one for Hill. Hill had a man all over him, and it's going to be DeShepper, and he's going to two-mark. Severson is the leading point tallier for the Chill. That's his team-leading 39th point. That's his 15th goal of the season. Colonials still have a minute 14 of power play time. We'll see if there was an assist on that one. I think it's going to be Severson all by himself. That one is held in nicely at the line. Madsey has it, fakes the shot, sent it over to the outside. Now he'll get it back. Two-man game, that shot comes in, a save was made, and Yonke did a nice... Five-on-five hockey once again. That was Mishar. Misha Mishar had it momentarily for the Colonials. Now picking up the loose puck, that's Weber. He'll flip it over. And it's chucked all the way down the ice. That should be icing. Yes, 3-1. Be two assists on that goal by Severson. Hold that thought. Here's a chance for the Colonials. A shot off the crossbar. The player was celebrating. He thought it was in. That was a shot from Jimmy Dravage, and it hit off of the crossbar and stayed out of the net. Now, in the far corner, Severson had it. Wanted to play give and go there with his teammate, but that one didn't materialize. They're going to try and cycle this one out of the corner. That was Escobar, and then he lost control of it. Coffin plays it in on a delayed offside. Cooley tags up, and play continues on. is banked out to center and played. Backhand pass from Cope over to Donovan. Donovan is watched closely by Best at the side of the cage. Turner had a whack at it. Now here's Cope. Cope runs into Escobar. Turner is there also. Severson joins the party, and they jam away at it. It's pried loose, and it's held in at the left point by Skeens. And now it's magnetically attracted to the boards again. Now it twirls free. Robertson has it to Severson, and he'll gain the red line and then wrap that one around and head to the bench. O'Brien wanted to cut that one off, but he failed to do so. Best has it now at the right point. And then he gave that one up, and Skeens comes back the other way for the Colonials. He'll go cross corner. Coffin will be the first to get to that one. High off the boards, and he'll play it back into the Colonial zone, where Skeens has it again. Sends it to the near boards. Nobody home but the first. Palomeque won the draw there. But now here comes Fondadous. Fondadous in stride to Pollitt. He's got a man with him, but the puck was bouncing and hopping all over the place. He couldn't find Kismatulin on that one. Out to center with it. That was Palomeque. O'Brien out for a skate. He'll flip that one, and that one just stays stuck on the boards. Now it's on the end boards. Four men kick it free momentarily. Now from around the cage out front, they had a man. Turnaround shot was blocked. Held in. Nice block there by Brady Hill. Now turning away from traffic, Kismatulin with it. Kismatulin up high in the slot, takes the shot, and that's punched aside by O'Brien to the far corner. Here's Fondadous. He's got it. He'll swing it up top. Pollitt shot off the mark. With it, Kismatulin. Good zone time here for Cooley. They run a great cycle. They were trying to hit the man on the backside. He had crept down from his point position. That was Dent. And now DeShepper swings that one over to Dent. Dent hits Drews. Drews toe drag, but Wojciechowski read that one well. Tried to clear it, but Dent will keep that one in for the chill. Look at there. That was Kismatulin. After it is Drews. Colonials have it. They'll cycle it the other way for Skeens. Wojciechowski to Skeens. Just a game of keep away so far. And then that one is loft goal. 17-21. There's a shot and a save, and then the rebound was right out front. Player couldn't capitalize on that one. 19 from 26. We'll see if there's a second assist on that one. The initial shot came from Dent. I was distracted by a couple of players that were tied up and refusing to let go of each other in the corner. The referee was working on them to unpry themselves. And while that was happening, Dent took the shot. The save was made by O'Brien. And there on the doorstep was Kismatulin to hammer that one home against an outstretched O'Brien. For Kismatulin, that'll be his seventh goal on the season. He leads the team with 26 assists. Gilbert will get an assist as well. Now the race is on. Vanderhoven has it. Shallow angle, takes the shot, puts it on the pad. Save was made by O'Brien. Played out to center. Robertson couldn't quite command that one. Now he'll retrieve it. He's got a man draped all over him in Machar. To the inside of Dent. sort of cartwheeled over him, and I thought it looked like a legit check. What do I know? I'm up here calling the game. And the rules of hockey have changed so much over the years that somebody who's 52 like me hasn't always adapted so well to the new rules of play. Here come the Colonials. They'll see if they can get their power play untracked. They've allowed a shorthanded goal already in this game. Madsey sends that one around. That'll be picked up by the opposition, Kismatulin. Now with it, and some room is Mishar. He swings it up ahead to Turner. Turner sends it in and then gets it by Mastroni. And then Severson takes it back. Severson shovels it over to his partner, and that was turned over. Now behind the cage. With it there, that's Westendorf. It's flipped out to the point, gloved, set down. The shot was deflected, and that went over the cage. The initial shot came from Skeens. That shot right on, a save. The puck was loose, and then it's banked all the way down. That's going to come in on O'Brien, and he'll play that one out to center. Severson guns that one in. Looked like it was offside. O'Brien certainly was shouting that from his cage. Now it'll be an icing call. The circle by Remsen. Face-off win for Fonda Deuce. Robertson shot, hit traffic, never made it through. Robertson has it. Vanderhoven got it up ahead. With it is Fonda Deuce to Vanderhoven. Fonda Deuce. I got all my names mixed up there. Back the other way. Here's Palomeque. He'll chip and chase. First to get to it. Now here comes Paulett. Paulett was watched closely. Nice shoulder check there by McCormick on Mastroni. Paulett has got somebody's stick in his equipment. It was the stick of Barry. Held in by Dent. Kismatulin wanted to feed one down low to McCormick, but the defenseman laid out to take away that potential pass. Now it's Dent, but that one hopped over his stick, and it's played out to center by Paulett. Dent has it. He'll just ease that one into the zone and then scoop to the bench and be replaced on the D-line. Not the D-line, how about the blue line? We're mixing football and hockey up here, folks. This is about the 18th game I've called in the last 3 days. Tape-to-tape passing, but that pass just bounced off of Turner's stick. Now here's Best. On the right wing, he gets it to Escobar. Escobar glides into the attacking zone and then had it stripped from behind. Skeens settles things down and then banks that one to Lefkoff. Up ahead, that one is touched out of the zone by Mastroni. After the puck for the Colonials there was Brandon Cope. And we get a whip. Jacob Best, third on the team in assists, second in points. That's his first point of this afternoon's game, though. He trails Severson now. Here's Kismatulin, sends it over. That shot is ripped, and a nice save is made by McCormick will step in to take the draw against Weber. Weber wins it and gets it over to Skeens. Skeens puts on the brakes, surveys the ice, tries it up the right side, but that pass bounced off the stick of Remsen. A shot by McCormick. Save was made by O'Brien. Here's Remsen. He lost the puck to Weiser. Now a twirling, whirling puck will come in, and O'Brien will play that out to center, up to Remsen. Remsen sends it in deep, and then takes his spot on the blue line. There's Madsy. He'll leave it off for Skeens. Skeens weaves through traffic, takes a shot. Pad save was made by Yonke. Picked out of midair by McCormick. He ducked under the check of Remsen. Remsen, one of the few players in the game that plays with just a half shield. Most of the players. Now with it is Cherry. He'll circle in his own zone and then banks that one, but that's not going to be cleared. Got bailed out a little bit there by his teammate, DeShepper. Loose puck, Kizmatulin will drop that one back to Cherry. Cherry banks that one out to center. Lefkoff will play that back into the Colonials end with 4 minutes and 33 seconds remaining. Here's a chance for the Colonials. That shot was lifted over the net by McEnany. He had a step, didn't have a whole lot of time. Got the shot off, however. Now a couple of touch passes up ahead. Here's Fondadouze. Whips it over in stride to Kizmatulin. He was hog-tied and spun around, no call. And then the puck is chucked out of play. Cooley closing in on a win here. That would be their second in a row. That would also vault them into second place in the Central Division. The game previous to this, the team that's leading the division, the team they're chasing, the Rochester Grizzlies, won their game. So they'll still stay 3 points behind the Grizzlies. The Grizzlies have one game in hand, by the way. Escobar got that one up ahead to Severson. Severson couldn't do much with it. Best to Severson. Severson gets around the defenseman, feeds it down low to Best. Shot, save. It's held in. Here's DeShepper. Left circle. He'll take the shot. Didn't miss by much on the far side. Puck comes all the way around back into the chill zone where it's gathered in by Ch-